Come on. This is cinematic. I said I would get cinematic.
Look at this. And I'm telling you, nobody walked through this path for the 3 hours that I was sitting there last time. Actually, one person, my brother, and that was by mistake. My brother and his girlfriend came here. Complete mistake. They didn't know I was here. I mean, look at this place. Look at this place.
The last few times I've come, this little creek has been completely dry, but I guess it's rained a few times, so now there's a little bit of water. But sometimes it's like flooding, like very high, so this is still quite low. So wild. And this is the spot that I've been painting. That tree right there. You probably recognize it from the other paintings. I think I should find a new spot. So let's go do that.
I'm gonna remind you and myself, I'm trying to get better. And the person I'm most inspired by right now is an artist called Andrew Gifford. And he'll go out and he'll make, I mean, this is a little bit bigger. And for some reason he uses more square canvases or boards. But he'll make like an impression of what he's seeing. And he'll study, usually what I gain from it is that he's studying the movement of something, the lighting on something, and it's not usually too complicated. There's probably one shape of a tree or a plant or a thing, and there's a few layers, but it's pretty simple. And then the point is that when he gets back into the studio, he uses all of these things that he's absorbed and that he's gathered, and he makes a big canvas with it. And so they're all studies of what he's looking at. They're studies of the nature, they're studies of the lighting, they're studies of the trees and the plants, whatever it is. And I really resonate with this perspective or this attitude towards painting. I like the idea of going out and getting studies, almost like getting downloads of what I'm seeing, just as a way to learn, but also as a means of producing in my mind what I can put onto a bigger canvas or what my final product can be. Okay, let's find a spot.
All right, sorry, I'm so all over the place, guys, that you're gonna have to get used to that if you watch my videos. But I wanna say this before I forget it. My biggest obstacle as an artist right now is that I'll overwork things. I don't know when to stop. And sometimes I overwork something and it just gets worse and worse and worse. When in the beginning, when it looked undone, it was actually the best. Maybe today I'll try to be super concise, not feel the need to overwork areas to make them look good, but just to get the essence of them, just immediately, and just be happy with it, you know? In one of my favorite paintings ever that I've made, a lot of the aspects of the painting were like first drafts, and I was planning on going over them later, which gave me the confidence to be like, this isn't the final edition, but it ended up being the final edition because it had that confidence and rawness in it, you know? So that's interesting. I'm gonna learn from that. Trust me, guys. You'll see. All right, so this is definitely gonna be a challenge for me, but what's catching my eye right now is the ground here and what colors I will use for this shadow versus the highlight. And I think I'll have the top of my canvas stop right about there so that I can get that bridge in and add some depth to the background. And then, you know, the side will be here and here. I'll include this tree. But the main thing that I want to focus on is getting this lighting to be captivating and to be, you know, not like realistic. I'm not, you know, a realism painter, but to get some of the energy and what makes this special, what makes that relationship what it is to us, to our eyes, to get that on the canvas in some way. Okay, well, this is cool. I'm holding this big rig. Look at this thing. You can't see it, but it's like a big, look how far I can hold it. All right. Good. update. It's been exactly 1 hour. So I'm gonna go back in and develop this and then come back here and keep pushing it forward. So it's not perfect, but I'm gonna stop now because I did what I wanted to do. And I honestly don't think that even if I spent another hour on this, it would get much better. I think that I need to get comfortable with looking at it and knowing that it could be better. And also knowing that I've accomplished what I wanted to accomplish. The work is the prize. The work is what I want. The result is not necessarily what I want. I mean, the product isn't the result. The product is the work. You know what I mean? So I'm happy with the work that I put into this. Like when you look at it from far, you can see that it's shining. You can see that that's a forest floor, and you can see that that's a tree. And then maybe you can see that's a bridge. I'm not sure. That honestly, this sounds like a silly excuse, and it is, but I got a lot of new paints, and when I poured them out, if you can see right there, a lot of the liquid came out. If you're a painter, you know that that happens. And so this canvas is super wet. Like, do you see it glistening? So like, it was hard for me to put wet paint on that without it mixing. So like, this bridge right here is kind of like a grayish, bluish color. But over there, it's a bright, you know, I was gonna put like a yellow or something. Kind of like a purple and yellow contrast. But as much as I tried to lighten the yellow and put it on there, it just kept mixing with what's behind it because it was wet. So I guess I just have to be comfortable with it not being perfect. But I like the movement. I like it goes up like this, and then it comes across like that, and goes in like that. It comes together at some point right there, you know, that light. You see how that tree there, those two trees right in the middle, have a highlight on the right side. And this tree, you can't see it as much. It used to have more of a highlight on that right side. I used an orange to show the highlight, and then a green behind it over a purple to show the end. I don't know why, but I think it brings it to life more. Just little things like that are why I'm doing this. You know, just having to make a quick decision with the color like that to make it look like what I'm doing. So there you go. Happy. Moving on. And that only took me an hour and a half. It's only 12:45. This morning I went to the gym. I had breakfast. I put out a video titled Why I Decided to Pursue My Dream, where I just explained, I was just standing over there and I just explained it like to myself to just remember. Back to the studio. I'm trying my best to get it on. Not everybody makes it out alive when they are young. I was in Tokyo showing off a crack, and you told me that I should not be doing that. Hey, I was in LA shaking my shit while you were down in Melbourne saying fuck that bitch. You're in New York getting shit on, and they were down in Melbourne saying you should not be doing that. Okay. See, the thing about these three is that I would assume that these two would be better than that, because with these two I spent 3.5 hours, and with this I spent 1.5 hours. But it just goes to show that I was just trying to show this sensation, to show this light. And all I did was make sure that I did the basic thing right, instead of making it 10% better with another 2 hours, you know? I just wanted to get the sensation, and then I moved on. And honestly, I think that this is more dynamic than the other two. Like, even this line right here, that branch, I spent so much time on to try to get the colors right. And with this branch, I spent 2 seconds because I just made one line like that. And I think that it's as good or even better in showing the light compared to that one. But you might have a completely different perspective. Who knows? Also, I should find a better way to show you these, because it's super dark over here. And there's actually a light behind it, so it makes it even worse.
I don't know.
but I actually like them.
If you're still watching this video, thank you. Comment or something like that so that more people like you can engage and find this video too. I appreciate you guys. See you next time. Bye.